That was awesome. I had to get down there where I could see it. Who put that together? Matt did. Yeah, would you do that for my service when the time comes? That was absolutely beautiful. You know, I just feel too far away up here. So I'm going to come down closer. We're a small group, and I'd rather be close to you all and to share in this time together. I want to thank you for the opportunity to be with you as family today, to remember Mom and Grandma and Great-Grandma Jackson, and just to celebrate her life. And I hope and I pray that today can be a time to really celebrate the beautiful person that you cherish today. I pray that as we're gathered together this afternoon, not only it'll be a time to honor God and to welcome God's presence with us today to comfort and to give us strength, but it'll also be a time for you to celebrate her life. 90 years old, 55 years of marriage. Does that sound right? Married in 1960. I tried to kind of put things together, but nice long years together, Lorraine and Bruce, and what a beautiful way to finish the pictures up there, together, one in spirit. So thank you again for allowing me to have this time with you today. And as we continue on, I invite you to join with me as we go to God in prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, I thank you so much, God, for the life of Lorraine Meyer. I thank you, God, for the blessing she has been. And just this brief little picture we've had of her life, we see the smiles, the joy, the laughter. We see the special times, the family times, God, all that was so important to her, Lord. We thank you, God. She has truly been a gift from you. And I pray, God, that this family will continue to cherish her in their hearts and their lives. I pray, God, that you will continue to be with them and to walk with them through not only today, but in the days and the weeks to come, Lord. And God, we thank you most of all that for us this is a time of victory. And we give you thanks for the victory that is ours in Christ Jesus. Because we serve and know the one who is the resurrection and the life. And in him, Lorraine is alive and lives forevermore. We thank you for that, God. And that she is held in your presence right now for all eternity. And so, Lord, may we have that image in our hearts right now of our loved one, Lorraine Meyer, being held by you. May we hold on to that image. And may it be not only a reason for hope for Lorraine, but also for ourselves, God. Knowing that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has removed the sting of death. And it is truly just a passing from one place to another, from one existence to another into your presence. And so we give you thanks in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I want to share with you a passage of scripture that was requested for today. Familiar passage, Psalm 23. But as I read it, I want you to keep in mind that this was written by David as a shepherd. And it was written out of his real life experiences of knowing God in a very personal and intimate way. And because David grew up as a shepherd, he used that as his image to think of himself and his relationship with God. And it's amazing throughout all of Scripture that motif of shepherd and sheep comes up again and again of God's care for us. And there's a reason for it, and I'll touch on that. But let me share with you these familiar words. The Lord is my shepherd. I lack nothing. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He refreshes my soul. He guides me along the right paths for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the darkest valley, Some translations say the shadow of death, where we're at right now. Even though I walk through that, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Right now, with you at this time. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. And I want to pause there for a moment too, because it's just a beautiful metaphor from Scripture of how God would use the whole idea of a banquet, a celebration of him being with his people. And the two greatest enemies of all humanity are sin and death, two things that can separate us from God. But because we serve a shepherd, Jesus Christ, who has soundly defeated both of them, he prepares a table for us in the presence of those enemies because we have victory. And as I was reading through this and thinking about this today, I was reminded of something that was shared with me about a week ago about a certain green desk that sometimes someone would have to go to when they were in trouble. A green desk. But this is a table of celebration. A table of celebration. You anoint my head with oil, the Holy Spirit. My cup overflows. The sheep would come in, the sheep would come past by the shepherd. There would be bugs and so forth caught around in their head. And it was so annoying and so frustrating to those poor, helpless sheep. And sometimes would cause them to even bring harm upon themselves, try to be free from the bugs and so forth caught in their head and in their wool. That the shepherd, as they would come in, he would anoint them with oil and rub it all over them to set them free from that. In the same way, he anoints my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely your goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever, forever. Amen. Now, I would like to share with you something that Lori prepared, writing up about her mom. I've read through this several times this past week, and I thought, boy, I can't even do this justice. So, Lori, I'm going to share your thoughts, if that's okay. Some of the things that you typed out, and if I embellish a little bit, is that okay too? Born in Owosso, Michigan, to Andrew and Esther Lewis, Lorraine grew up in Morrice. Now, I'm not originally from Owosso. Is it Morrice? I'm never sure if I'm saying it correctly. You all know. Grew up in Morrice Road on a farm south of town with her brother Marvin. Loved to go to her grandma and grandpa Carstensen. I'll try to get that out. Grandma and grandpa's farm. Sunday was the Sabbath, no working. I can relate to that back growing up. Wanted to play baseball in the Sunday afternoon. Nuh-uh. Sunday best and off to church, then to her grandparents. Eventually, the farm got to be too much for her parents, and they moved into town. She attended Owosso schools and graduated from Owosso High School in the class of 1948. She worked as an assistant for her Uncle Jim and Aunt, is it Hilah? I got it right. Hilah Douglas of Douglas Trucking. She earned a degree in 1958 from Lansing Business School. She married Bruce Meyer in 1960. In Bradenton, Florida, a homemaker, so she worked, her career kept her busy 24/7. A homemaker, raised three children, and she was Bruce's secretary for Meyer Refrigeration and Air-Conditioning. She loved her family, especially her grandkids. They would always call grandma when they got in trouble, and she would say to them, "Oh, that's not so bad." And then she would add, "She did a lot worse," evidently referring to you, Lori. Yeah. Were you the problem child? She She loved conversation. She enjoyed whoever she was with, truly interested in their life. And I experienced that too. After services that she'd walk by and she would just give me her attention, her eyes sparkling and chatting with me after she gave me approval for whatever tie I had on. "You are my favorite," she would end a family or dear friend conversation with. The favorite was with her in the moment. The last few years she lived in the moment. She enjoyed her moments. We'd all do well to follow that example. "What trips do you have planned? What's on the agenda? Don't sweat the small stuff," she would say. She enjoyed bridge with her lifelong girlfriends. She was always on the go, and I could picture that. It came up again and again. Walks, car rides, especially in the country, and Marion Springs, where her relatives were from, always looking for red barns. She loved to go on trips, especially trips. After retirement, Lorraine and Bruce developed a love for travel, oftentimes with Lorraine's brother, Marv, and her sister-in-law, Joyce. She traveled the U.S. and overseas together. Summers for 24 years with Bruce and family on Mullet Lake. She loved the lake. Loved to go anywhere anyone would ask her to go. And I love this line from your mom. "Make sure you want me to go with you, because if you ask, I will say yes." I love that line. I'm going to remember that. Greatest, in this paragraph, greatest generation, golden rule, work ethic, respect for others, courteous, good listener, moral fiber, right and wrong, but would listen to why there is gray, churchgoer, good friend, helper, volunteer, happy, love to laugh, love to sing. That was that generation. Beautiful. Thank you, Lauren, for sharing that, Lori. Loved her church family. She was an avid church member of First United Methodist Church for over 50 years. As a part of the women's group, she enjoyed working with the church rummage and helping to host events in the fellowship hall. She volunteered at Memorial Healthcare in the gift shop. She loved seeing people, and you could see that. You could tell that about her. She loved dark chocolate. Did any of you inherit that love from her? Any dark chocolate lovers here? No? She loved to bake pies, her specialty, French apple pie. Doesn't that sound heavenly right now? French apple pie, molasses cookies, and peanut brittle. She loved a party, but never for herself. She did not want the attention. Always dressed just right, always earrings on. Listen to this. Prayed as her mother did. Every day, pray for your president. You know, the Bible says we should pray for our leaders, whether we agree with them or not. As a Christian, we're called to pray for our leaders. Doesn't matter where you're coming from politically. We have to raise the standard and pray for them. Every day, pray for your president. Pray for your country. Amen. And give thanks. Amen. Okay, I have shared that. Now, I would like to, if any would like to share something about Mom or Grandma, I want to offer you the opportunity to do that. If you would like to share, if you want what you're saying to be on live stream, you'll have to go up to the microphone. But if you'd rather not, if you want to just stand where you're at, I want to give you that opportunity. Does anyone have a brief memory or something you'd like to share? And if you don't tell the CDC, when you get up to talk, I'll let you take your mask off so we can hear you. Anybody? anybody anything you want to share? I want to give you that opportunity. Probably thinking, well, Lori took it all when she wrote down those thoughts. All righty. I don't know if Jackson has anything to say. Talking about our Lord being the shepherd, that beautiful metaphor throughout all of Scripture, God is the shepherd and we as the sheep. God's intention was to use human vessels, but hundreds of years after David's time, God was not pleased with how they were shepherding his people. And God spoke through the prophet Ezekiel in chapter 34 and said, I'm going to shepherd my sheep. I'm going to take care of them. And about 500 years after Ezekiel spoke those words, we read of Jesus in the temple in Jerusalem, surrounded by not just disciples, but also his adversaries, challenging him. And in John 10, beginning at verse 11, he spoke these words, I am the good shepherd. Here I am, just as God promised, in human flesh. The word of God become flesh, dwelling among us. God coming to us in the most incredibly personal and intimate way to walk among us. We don't have to go after God. We don't have to try to pursue God. God has come to us. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. And that's the way it was for shepherds of that time. They had to defend the sheep. Earlier on in the same passage, Jesus said, I'm the gate for the sheep. See, in the nighttime, the shepherd would bring his sheep to a corral, bring them into the corral, and there wasn't a gate to close, so the shepherd himself would lie down in front of that opening so that if a predator came along or a thief, they'd have to get past the shepherd. I laid down my life for the sheep, which is exactly what Jesus did for us on a cross. The good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. The hired hand is not the shepherd and does not own the sheep. So when he sees the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. Then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it. The man runs away because he is a hired hand and cares nothing for the sheep, but our Lord does for each and every one of us. And then he reiterates that same truth. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. That relationship that he offers. As we read in Psalm 23, the Lord is my shepherd, and I know him, and he takes care of me, and he leads me, and he guides me. He feeds me. He feeds my soul. And even when I'm going through the most difficult valley that any human being has to face, he's still with me. As the Bible says in Hebrews 13:5, he'll never leave us nor forsake us. I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep and my sheep know me. Just as the Father knows me and I know the Father. And then he says again, and I lay down my life for the sheep. Sheep are always on the move. Always on the move, always having to be led, always having to be taken care of and cared for. They're demanding. They're 24/7 for a shepherd, especially the one who owns the shepherd. Came up and again how Lorraine liked to journey. She liked to be on trips. She liked to go traveling. She liked to go for walks. And as she would walk, she would count cigarette butts along the way. She liked red barns. She enjoyed seeing red barns. We have that adventure spirit. We were created that way. We were created to be people on a journey of life. And that's what life is all about. And our shepherd has promised that I want to walk with you. I want to be with you all the time, through the high points and the low points. And yes, we go through the low points. We're going through one right now. Our whole, not just our nation, our whole world, a dreadful pandemic. Absolutely dreadful, and it has touched you personally with Lorraine's life. It's very real. That's why we have to wear these. And we have to be careful, and we have to use hand sanitizers. And I've heard people say, why is God allowing this? And my response back to them is, nowhere in the Bible does God ever say that life is going to be fair. He doesn't. In fact, God says the exact opposite. Jesus said in John 16:33, in this world you will have trouble. Because it's a broken system. It's broken. And we see that manifested in the way people are treating each other. We've seen it firsthand, and we're seeing it again and again. And our shepherd knows that. He knows that sometimes we're not always going to be on the mountaintop or by the still waters, but sometimes we're going through that shadow. He says, I'm with you. I'm with you on this journey. Just as he is with Lorraine. We go through many journeys in our lifetime. Lorraine had so many in her life. I've shared with you her accomplishments, and you've known her as mom, and you've known her as working with her husband. I don't know how they pulled that off. Not every husband and wife can work together. Nancy and I have tried hanging wallpaper together. That's a real, that makes memories. But she went through all of those journeys, and she's been a mom, and she's been a grandma, and she's been a part of this church. And 90 years, a plethora of wealth, of wisdom, you could probably pick her brain and so forth. And now she's made the greatest journey of all with that same shepherd. Towards the end of the sixth chapter of John, it's a long chapter in the Gospel of John, comes to a point where many of the people just don't want to hear what Jesus has to say anymore, and they're walking away, they're leaving. And Jesus looked at the 12 and he said, do you all want to leave me too? He doesn't force anybody to follow him. And Peter spoke up and said, Lord, to whom shall we go? We believe you have the words of life. We want to follow you. We want to follow you. Remember what I read? Where's that line? Where, make sure you want me to go with you, because if you ask, I will say yes. What Lorraine said. Our Lord's like that. When you say, Lord, I want you with me, make sure you mean it, because he'll say yes. Because he wants to be with you, and just as he was with Lorraine through all of this, her life. You know, as I was listening to watching the slides and listening to that fun music, was anybody tapping their foot during that? And I was listening to that song, and I was seeing the beautiful pictures up here on the screen and the smiles and the so forth. The thing that came to my mind was, you see, that's what it's all about. That's what our Lord wants us to experience in life. Laughter and joy. He wants to be with us, and he wants to walk with us. And I've always said, if people aren't finding reason to smile when they're in church, then we're doing something wrong. We're doing something wrong. Lorraine knew that, and she shared that. Sheep are always on the move. If you ask me to go with me, you better mean it, because I'm going to say yes. And that's the way the shepherd is. Just as he's always been with Lorraine, he wants to be with all of us, all of you, walking with him. I liked reading the words that Lori had written down about whoever Lorraine was with was her favorite at the time. Am I getting that right? That means I was her favorite pastor. I'll take it. But you know, she did make you feel that way. I'd be standing out back after the service, and Laurie and Lorraine would come through, and on Communion Sundays, as I was telling you the other day, I'd have on my robe for Communion Sunday, but when I saw Lorraine coming, I'd make sure I unzip so she can see the tie. So I'd pass inspection of the tie, and she'd look at me right in the eyes, and she would smile, and there's the gleam that in her eyes, you know, the sparkle in her eyes right there. And she just kind of made me feel like in that moment, I'm her favorite. I hold on to that. And every one of you hold on to that too, that you are her favorite. Something else I want you to hold on to is that you're his favorite. You're his favorite too. Just as Lorraine was his favorite. If you read a little further in this 10th chapter of John, you'll find a place where Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice, they know me, they follow me, I give them eternal life, and nothing will snatch them from my hand." She is forever held in his hand, just like all of us. Amen. I'm going to close in prayer, and we're going to get ready and head over to Hillcrest Cemetery to have a time together. But as we process out, there's going to be another fun song playing too. Another fun song. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for the Good Shepherd who has laid down his life for the sheep. We thank you, God, that he has a hold of Lorraine Meyer. Never going to let go. She is safe in his grip. And I pray that this family, God, will be comforted by that beautiful thought, that truth. I pray that you give them strength, Lord. I pray, God, that as the memories continue to filter through their hearts and minds, that you will bless them, Lord. They will cherish these memories. Cherish the smiles and the laughter and the good times as family. Bless them, I pray, God, in the days, the weeks, the months to come. And may they always be reminded that you're the Good Shepherd. You are the Good Shepherd, and we thank you for that. In Jesus' name, amen.
Time I could afford. that all aboard. Could be so yearning. Why did I decide to roam? Gotta take that sentimental journey.